Today's scripture readings tell us that we are God's stewards, that is, managers of God's gifts and resources, and that God expects faithful and prudent stewardship from us. Our God-given talents and blessings, like wealth and many other resources placed under our care, and that we should render an account without practicing corruption. In the first reading from the book of Amos 8:4-7, the prophet of social justice condemns the crooked business practices of his time, namely by the merchants of Judea, that he reminds the Israelites and also today's audience to be faithful to our covenant with Yahweh, God of justice. We need to practice justice and mercy to all as God's faithful managers. Prophet Amos warns us also against making money by any means as the goal and purpose of our life to satisfy our greed and avarice. The Psalm number 118 reminds us that the all-seeing God protects and cares for the poor, the section of people whom we should also care and help. In the second reading from 1 Timothy 2, 1-8, Paul instructs the first century Judeo-Christians to become true stewards of the gospel of Jesus, the only mediator, by preaching the good news to the pagans and by including them in their intercessory prayers. In the gospel from Luke 16:1-13, Jesus tells the parable of the dishonest manager who had been cunningly and unjustly handling and managing the wealth of the rich master. This gospel passage is rather difficult to understand even by scripture scholars. Verse 8 is the primary reason, which says, "And his master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly, for the children of this age are more cunning and intelligent in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light." It means the worldly people are more intelligent in their material pursuits than God's people are in their spiritual pursuit. This verse challenges us to use our blessings, time, talents, health, and wealth wisely and justly so that they will be our means of blessings here on earth and enable us to attain the lasting reward in eternity. Every gift of God has a purpose, and we should wisely discern the purpose of the gift of God to us. And the blessings of God will multiply in our lives, and we shall be greatly rewarded in heaven. Finally, today's gospel reading ends with these words of Jesus: "No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth." The two masters in life are, first, God, and second, material things and money of this world. The big question is, which or who do we choose, God or money? The decision that we take will determine the path of our spiritual life.